Super Herd and welcome back to Pokémon Quest. I do want to say really quickly, I have been getting your feedback loud and clear, but since I'm on schedule, I do record some of these episodes ahead of time. I'm recording this before episode 3 releases. That should be releasing early, like later today for me. But we got a new Pokémon because I accidentally opened this up, as you can see, and I closed the game because I didn't want to see what it was. I didn't mean to. I was leveling up Pokémon. I'll be going into that in just a second, but it looks like it was Cubone. How exciting! I love that little guy. Okay, so he became our buddy. But yeah, we're gonna open up all these pots. A lot has been updated, well not updated in the game, but like I have been updating my team a lot. I've been trying to level up Pokemon to make sure we survive World 4. And I can only hope it works out this time. I really don't wanna leave without it being done, but we got another Mulligan Stew out of cube right here. I earned up a ton of materials, so many of them. What in the world is that thing? I guess we're about to find out. Hey, look at that, it's an Abra. Very cool. That's a new Pokemon for us for sure. And then down this way, we got two more cooking pots left to open. Lots of exciting stuff going on in today's episode though, I hope. Another Mulligan. Come on, what do we got, what do we got? Oh, I forget what it's called, but I know exactly what it is. Ghastly, I think? No, it's coughing. Hey, buddy, how you doing? So he has one of these combo slots where he can put a damage or a health there, which is pretty cool. And then lastly, we got ourselves another cooking pot over this way. And this one has a one. Ooh, this one is a bluish Pokemon. I don't know if that's new or not, but we got two. Nice, we got two Pokemon out of it. What do we get? Oh, so first off, we got ourselves Machop. I think this is our first ever Machop. That's super exciting. I like it. And then also we got over there, this little guy. He is a Horsea. You're so cute. You're level 12 too. You're a water type, so you're definitely gonna be worthwhile. Very cool stuff. So let's take a look at our cooking pots here. You might see that we got a number of things going on. First off, we have tons and tons of materials. I have 10 of these now. So if we do wanna upgrade our cooking pot and just try to auto set and see what it does use all 10 of these. I don't know if that's a good idea though. I'm thinking that we should actually spread those out a little bit more. So it's just, yeah, set it back like that and try something like that. Okay. And then go over here. But you can tell I have like tons of these different berries and like ice things. There we go, I wanted to use three of those somewhere. And then we could use like a bronze one. I just wanted to make sure those rarer rainbow ones end up doing something worthwhile for me. So let's go ahead and try this out, just like that. That's gonna be a bronze cooking pot, so it should increase the chance of it being a more powerful Pokemon, which can be nice. And we'll do another bronze one, actually. Go ahead and do this, and then that should be good. Okay, so let's see what that kind of stuff ends up being. I'm trying not to sneeze. I'm trying really, I failed. I totally failed in the sneezing department. I'm so sorry. And we also have some quests. Oh, actually no quests, but a bunch of challenges completed. We got five of these, so let's go ahead and take them. I need to check to see if we have any more available, but I definitely wanna do some upgrading with these maybe at the end of today's episode. There's another five, another five, another five. And another five. So we're all the way up to 70. We also got some new ingredients, 5 balm mushrooms, 5 icy rocks, 5 more icy rocks. Wow, lots of quests. Got 5 more. Another 5 honey. Very, very good stuff right here. So that should be everything. Yep, looks like it. Let us head back then and see what else is going on. I think that's about it. So you might see that my team is a little bit interesting. It's Pidgeotto, Zubat, and Spearow, because I learned something between the fourth episode and this episode, which is the fact that that flying type bonus, it actually stacks. So as you can see here, we have a 2594 team with 1,296 as our bonus, because it triples. If I were to leave one of these, it would be 2/3. You know, if like we put Charmander here instead, it would be 2/3 of what this is. So in total here, we have like what, 3,794. So that should get us at least not to 4-4, which totally stinks. But maybe we could try some of this stuff out. Beyond that, I have upgraded all their stats. I felt so bad when this happened, but we did get our first evolution. Is this Pidgeotto? Yeah, in the back over here. Pidgeotto was Pidgeot before, you might remember, and then evolved into Pidgeotto. Spearow is level 19. I'm thinking that if he gets level 20, he's so close, he might actually evolve as well. I know Zubat can go into Golbat, I think it is. So like there's plenty, plenty of possibilities for everything. If we look into what other Pokemon we have, I don't think we have any repeats right now. But if we do find some, that'll be good. Because you guys have actually been letting me know a lot of info. Like if you see this guy right here, we actually have multiple Krabbies. So we can maybe cash in one of those guys. But if it's the same type, it should give you an even bigger bonus. If it's the same species. So if we use this Krabby to train that Krabby, it would give us a lot of experience. So those are good stuff to keep in mind. Maybe we should just save some of our stuff for right now. When it comes to the power charms, this is where I want to mix up with a lot of stuff. I'm just not on the right character. Can I go back? So I want to mix with our current team. Yeah, so let's go to your power charms and make sure we have the most powerful power charms we can get right now. As you can see, it looks like it. I'm a lot better off with these at the moment than I used to be, which is great. And I'm super glad to see it. So just looking back here, yeah. Okay, we're all good to go. We even had a couple more of these stones. So we have the weightless stone, more weight, move weight time has been lowered. Of course, we already had that. The attack with the broad burst stone we've already had. No, that was the scattershot stone. But now we have the broad burst stone, which makes it so the attack width is larger for some things. I'm still trying to figure out what that really does, but I think we'll be able to tackle this stuff a little bit easier. I think that we might actually start with the first level again. Just to get some extra experience as we head in, it'll be a little bit easier for us because with even without the bonus, we should be good enough to get this done. So let's hope that everything goes well with our team. I have been really benefiting. Oh yeah, this is on auto. Sometimes I was just leaving it on auto. That's sort of a big training tip. If you don't have enough time to play the game, I was just replaying this level on auto over and over again, earning up tons of materials that way until I ran out of battery. I mean, I don't want to play on auto when I'm recording for you guys, because I feel like that's a little bit boring, but for when I'm just, you know, out here like this, it's great. And it gets us a lot of materials. It feels like we get more materials the additional times we play these levels than the first time we play them. But yeah, it seems like Zubat has Supersonic, which sort of stuns people. Pidgeotto has Gust, and then he also has Whirlwind. We know that Spearow has Takedown, and those are all pretty good. Zubat also has Leech Life, which will heal him a little bit, which can be very helpful. We got more of those rare rainbow things. That's gonna be great. And I just wasted that. So yeah, very, very awesome stuff. I've been having a lot of fun playing it off camera, but I don't want to do more than I have to. I want to keep as much on camera as possible. It just, this episode would be like, or this series would be way too long if I had all the grinding. It would probably get really boring, so I don't want to do that. But the whirlwind move for Pidgeotto is pretty nice. The thing is, I also learned about a number of different things as well you guys have been giving me awesome hints for. One of them, oh no, poor Spearow got taken down. But like even then, like we have so much more points in this, Pidgeotto's still getting taken out, you know? Or Spearow is. Like that's just really confusing to me. It's like how much more powerful do we have to be? I don't really get it. But regardless, there are ranged Pokemon and close range Pokemon, and it depends on your combo will depend on how much of a reach you have. So we got 51 materials there and a new power stone, which is awesome. But you can actually tell by this symbol here. So Pidgeotto is ranged. Spearow evolving, here we go, yeah! Let's see what it turns into, I totally forget. Oh, it's Spearow! Oh, that's so cool, look at him! I'm so happy right now! Congratulations, your Spearow evolved into a Spearow! I am so happy, look at him! But you can tell by these symbols that we have arranged, and then a melee, so that's the formation. They have like a bit of a triangular formation where he's gonna be in front, which is why you probably don't want all flying, you probably want Snorlax in front to defend these two. But for now, this seems to be getting us somewhere good. If we continue on, you can see we got a bunch of materials, but more importantly, we got ourselves another Sturdy Stone at 175. Doesn't have any kind of special addition to it, but I feel like that could definitely be helpful. But yeah, we got that completed. We're now at 3,000 points even with the 1497 bonus. The bonus gets even more for more this number is. So that's pretty crazy. So with all of that being said, I still don't know what this meter is. I think this is a meter of the typings you'll find. So maybe like a lot of fighting and then like electric and water. I don't know. That little meter doesn't make too much sense to me. It's weird that there's a color for different types because a lot of the colors seem to intertwine in a weird way. I don't know. Okay, so wild Pokemon are coming, not a problem. I think we'll actually be able to handle everything, but I haven't played this level since, you know, last episode, because I didn't want to accidentally complete it or anything. That would be scary, you know? Anyways, we got Leech Life, we got Gust. The Whirlwind's hard to aim, so I try just to keep with the Gust with all of that, and then we'll do Takedown every once in a while. But Spearow is so cool! I'm like so happy to see that. Okay. I'm determined to complete this world in today's episode or get as close as physically possible. We're surrounded, that's fine. Do Leech Life real quick, because Leech Life really hurts. Okay, now that we're surrounded, we can try this move a little bit more. That sort of worked. So Firo, make sure you do your takedown just like that, do a gust towards this guy, and then leech life them, because it does a ton of damage sometimes. Yeah, that did 1,000 damage, it's crazy. Okay, wave cleared there, we're moving up here. So here's Ninetales. This is the guy who keeps beating our butts. It really hasn't been anything else but him. So if we could just go for him. I'm a little nervous because, you know, Firo did get taken out before, or when he was Spearow still. Oh, we got more rainbow stuff there, awesome. Okay, so now it's just us and Ninetales, but that can still be tough. Takedown, got it, and then do Gust, and then, oh boy, come on, come on, come on. Let's do Supersonic, you're a little too far out there. Zubat, I wish you would get a little bit closer. There goes Firo. Okay, so we're gonna do Gust, and then we're gonna do Life. We got him! Nice, we took him out! I'm so happy! I'm so very happy! Look at all the material we're getting. Yeah, it's definitely not as much. Before we got one stone and 50 materials. This time we only got 34. So I don't know why you get more materials the next time you do it, you know, instead of the first time. But we got more rare materials there for sure. That is so exciting. So we got some cooking pots finished as well. One of our bronze ones, which is awesome. I don't know how many bronze cooking pots we'll do, but we'll try to, you know, do it as much as we possibly can. So what is this gonna be? Ooh. Mulligan still on a cube. Nothing crazy there, but hopefully we can get a nice high level Pokemon. It's gonna be another Geodude. Okay. And here he is. What level is he? He's level 19. Crazy, crazy stuff. I mean, I might wanna get something like that in my team. It's just a matter of his HP is quite low. His HP and attack are quite low. So I just don't know if that's worth it. Well, it's good to get another one. So yeah, we're gonna go into here and see what else we can. We can auto set just like that and start our cooking. Hopefully we get some good stuff from that. Okay, so let's take a look at what we got from our quests. Hopefully something good is there as well. And we got 5 more tickets. Very good. So one thing that's important to also take a look at when we're choosing between like our multiple Geodudes or our multiple, I think we have more than one Onix right now as well. One thing to keep in mind, oh, what are you doing up here? Sandshrew. Did some Pokemon just show up? Because we had a Pikachu up here last episode that was really confused about. 23. Wow, okay, so you're very high level. But you don't have many stats. You know, that's something we gotta keep in mind. look at these two. It's so cute. But, oh yeah, we got our tickets as well. Let's go ahead and get those. Because the sooner we activate them, the sooner we can get more. So, gladly we'll take those. And then for our decorations, we still can't afford too much, but we should probably buy this now. I shouldn't wait till the end of the episode because the sooner I can get this stuff, the more drops I can get. And then we'll probably save up 300 for the size of yellow ingredients drops, I think. What are some of these other flags? Experience received from level up training. Nice. What about you? Okay. Ditto balloon, increase rate of move learning training. Okay. This stuff is very interesting. Not all of it do I need, but I'll keep it all in mind. So we should be good to go. I can go to the expeditions now. I actually might want to check out to make sure we have the best power stones we can possibly get at the moment. Because while our power might be higher, some of these actually have special effects, right? So like this one's 175, this one's 169, but it has HP upon recovery, which can be better than, you know, not having anything. So that's sort of stuff we want to keep in mind. So like while this stone is better, I don't know if I'm actually going to apply it on anybody because everything else, every other health stone we have here has some kind of positive effect. So I'm going to hold off for now. But if we take a look, we're slowly getting more slots available for other Pokemon. If I take a look over here, we have almost another slot there. We're working up to it. If I can get Zubat into another level, I think that'll help big time, because I think he's gonna upgrade or evolve into a Golbat. I can only hope, right? Okay, so we're going against this guy. It's 3,000. In total, we have 4,497 as our score. So hopefully everything goes well. Maybe it's the farther you are in a world, more of a bonus it gives you. We'll have to find out, we'll have to check that next time. Okay, so which Pokemon are we dealing with? Okay, here we go, we got some wild Pokemon. But yeah, that's sort of another thing, is that we can teach Pokemon moves. And I feel like that's something I wanna do with Firo, because right now Firo still only has one move. I don't know if the Pokemon can learn new moves, or if it's just a matter of they only have the moves they had when you got them, and then you can teach them new ones. I'm pretty sure that's what it's gonna be. The problem with Firo is that he gets beat up real easy, so you just gotta be careful of that kind of stuff. Use takedown when we can. We need to find a way to bulk up Firo's health a lot more. I think that would help. But for right now, using Takedown will help. Maybe using Supersonic a little bit more. I need to check out what the usage of Supersonic is. Oh, it looks like Fearow already got taken out. Holy cow, that was quick. Come on, come on. We're able to get these guys. Luckily, you know, Pidgeotto and Zubat are pretty capable on their own. But I would like to help a Fearow. Okay, so we got a couple more things there. Come on, Fearow, you're almost back up. We've got, oh my gosh, a giant Rapidash. Okay. So, whoa, you were quick. You were really quickly attacking us. Attack, there we go, there we go, there we go. Okay, Life Leech on anybody, really? Okay, so, oh, you're really confused right now. Nice, because of the Supersonic, I think? I don't know, hard to tell, but we're gonna take advantage of it as much as we possibly can. Right now, the problem is that Zubat's a little occupied over there, so if we can make him use Life Leech, come on, get him. We're actually taking him out, though. Like, we're keeping up. Okay, come on, come on, guys, come on. Gust, Gust, yay, he took him out. Good job. So we are making our way through a little bit better. We got a lot more materials that time. Oh my gosh, a ton. So many, was that like an expedition bonus, maybe? Okay, so we got ourselves some level up. Still no Golbat. Maybe I'm wrong, maybe Zubat doesn't turn into Golbat. Or maybe, I don't know. Anyways, not gonna worry about it for right now. We got more level ups. Another Mighty Stone. It has critical damage plus 8%. That's very good. Tons and tons of materials. Necessary ingredients, amount of cooking, stronger Pokemon, blah, blah, blah. Okay, so let's check this out. What do we got? Challenges done. Got more big roots. Very cool. Got even more. See, we're just slowly building up. Whoa, the software needed to close due to an error. No, that stinks. I was doing something. Okay, so I am back now. It didn't seem like anything bad happened, but it's sort of hard to tell, to be honest with you. But yeah, we're just gonna go into this one now. Actually, let's check out our stones really quickly. Make sure we have the proper power stones, because we got some new ones that seemed pretty powerful, like this new attack stone. That'll be great for Pidgeotto, I think, because he has this like really weak one down here. Not only, but this will give him a higher crit chance, so that's a good little boost. And then we still have this really nice health stone, but I just don't think it's worth making the jump. I mean, maybe for critical hit rate up, that's what this does. So maybe this would be worth the jump because we get a lot of health out of it. I mean, Fearow hasn't been taking too much. No, Fearow's actually been taking a lot of damage. Anyway, we can help his health would be great. So we got that going on. Let's move on to 4-4 and hopefully we can get things done. Oh, we have too many power stones. Let's go ahead and recycle a couple. I try to recycle anything that has below 100 health, but we don't really have too much more of that. I'm thinking we can start recycling some of these in the back though. Anything that's less than 100 damage or 100 health, even if there's characters equipping it. So get rid of all of this. Oh, I can't right now because somebody has it equipped. Okay. We have all these lower damage stones, but I think I want to hold on to some of them. I think I'm gonna get rid of this and this. I think that'll be fine. So we'll recycle all of that. Sounds good to me. We got some materials for nothing crazy, but that'll give us enough room. I think that I'll probably purchase a like more upgraded space at the end of today's episode or something, I don't know. Okay, so our score right now is actually 45-23. What if I were to move back? Okay, so the bonus type, I don't know what it's determined about, but it definitely just gets higher and higher. Okay, well, I'm excited. Let's see what ends up happening. Expedition start. So we got Fearow over here. Let's see what he does. Okay, take this guy down. Boom, that was pretty good. Let's go ahead and do Whirlwind. Or maybe we should have done, you know what, we probably shouldn't have done that. Okay, we'll do that. I need to, like I said, I still haven't had the chance to check what Supersonic does. I think it confuses them, or at least has like a chance to. Wow, we are taking them out really easy. It's just Fearow takes so much damage all the time. Come on, come on, are you ready? Boom, and then we'll do Whirlwind. Yeah, that did some good damage. And then Leaf Life. I'm actually, like, as somebody who doesn't really like Zubat as a Pokemon in the actual Pokemon games, it's not that he's bad or anything, it's just that I usually don't find him all that interesting of a Pokemon. He's really good in this game. The Life Leech is really helpful. So I'm glad we have that. So what do we got going on now? Look at this, okay, we got Growlithe, right? That's Growlithe? Arcanine, okay, it's, I think the evolution of Growlithe. Okay, let's do this. They run up on you real quick, it's scary. Let's Supersonic and then we'll Gust. Oh gosh, you're going right after the Fearow. Come on, do this. Okay, and then Leaf Leech, Leech Life. No, you missed it. Oh, that stinks. Go ahead and do this move. That missed as well. That's just really awkward. Come on, Gust. No, come on. Okay, that did land on him. That's good. Get close, and then Leech Life. Got it. That was pretty good. So these two hold their own really well. So if we need to, unfortunately, it still seems like we should switch out Fearow. This is where a team of four would be really helpful. Come on, come on. Leech that life back. Okay, you got some of it back, and now you can focus on Fearow, right? I mean, maybe. Come on, come on, ready? Hit you with this. This guy is tough, though. He's not pulling any punches. We're trying to get him down, but it isn't easy. He's really just, like, does not like Pidgeotto right now. Come on, take down, take down. Got it. Now we can use Gust, and then we can move back to the Leech Life. That was good, that was good. He's almost down, he's almost down. Boom, and Fearow gets the takedown. That'll be good for his morale. Gets taken down so often. Taking down the boss will make him feel good, I would hope. We got, I think, yep, a stone there, very good. Ooh, we got level 21 with Zubat, almost level 21 with Pidgeotto. I don't know if Pidgeotto or Fearow have any more evolutions. I don't think they do. But we got a 250, that was a really good health stone right there. Once again, I think I'm gonna give that to Fearow. So we have our boss fight here, which is a little intimidating because I'm still not ready to take it on, but we also have a bronze cooking pot. So the game was very giving at first, but I feel like has really become overwhelming with how difficult it is. Okay, what do we got? Stone soup a la cube. Another Onyx, what do you know? That's crazy. How many of these guys have we gotten so far? What level are you? 16, not bad. Onyx became your buddy. So this is a sandstorm. The user creates a sandstorm to surround itself, damaging enemies that are hit by it. Okay. So there's that one done. We'll go ahead and fill this up again, and we'll have another one filled up next time. I think, we do have enough to do an auto set just like that. We're gonna be using 10 of these things, but we do get them a little more often now. So it's not the biggest deal in the world. So we'll do a bronze one more time. We have quests to deal with. Challenge, and more of these. Power recycler. I guess we're recycling the stones earlier. It doesn't matter too much right now. I'm gonna go ahead and upgrade with our extra tickets right now. I'm gonna go ahead and upgrade our box because I think we need it. The stone box, more than the Pokemon box right now, to be honest with you. Very, very good. So we should be able to move back now. And I wanna make sure that we have all the appropriate stones. And I think the best thing is making sure that Fearow here has the best health stone, which is 215, that's a lot, especially compared to what he currently has. And he'll get an upgrade for it. As you can see, time to recover percent is a lot less at 11.6, minus 11.6%, that's crazy. And then for Pidgeotto, I don't know if there's anything better we wanna give him. I don't think so. I mean, he's got a lot of good stuff right now. That's sort of like Pidgeotto is so good, is he has all these different colored stones that give him so many different things. And that's good to keep in mind. What about Zubat? I mean, he has this one damage stone that could be a little better, but I think it's fine. Zubat handles himself very well with his leech life. Okay, so that's the best we can do. We're at 3089. Will that be enough to take on this boss and win? I don't think so. Yeah, this will leave us at 4580, okay, like 46, so we won't have enough. That is such a huge jump. We'll try it once and see how things happen. If it doesn't work out, then we could always just grind up for the rest of today's episode. I feel bad because I want to do a world per episode, but I don't know if it'll actually be possible, especially if you run out of battery. There's not too much I can do about that at the moment. So yeah, right now let's just go ahead and do this. I'm gonna try to make sure all of our Pokemon are as protected as possible. Supersonic. Got it, and then do another takedown. These guys are real tough. It's scary. Come on, got one more. And Fearow is really hurting. Like, I honestly think it might still be better to have somebody like Snorlax on the team. Like, obviously, power level-wise, we won't be doing so well, but everything else would be great. Fearow's holding on, that's for sure. But it might be easier for him to get taken out now so that he can, there he goes. So he can be restored by the boss fight, because that's sort of a bit more of a scare at the moment. So get that going on, and then I don't think, we won't have to use Gust against you. New Pokemon appeared, or more one. This is a, forget what this, Mankey, I think? At least maybe the evolution of Mankey. Okay, got it. Move back over here and get you with this. Not bad. And let's try to use takedown. Okay, I actually did just barely time that correctly. I'm trying to keep them away from Fearow at the moment. It's not easy. I mean, I could try using this a little bit. I don't know if it really helps too much. That didn't really seem to do too much at all. Okay, got it. And we got him, okay. So yeah, what does this do? I don't know, it's a little odd. Okay, so we got these guys over this way, so let's go ahead and hit them with Gust right away, and then we'll hit them with the takedown, and then supersonic them, just like that. They're about to take him out again. I'd rather them not do that. Leash life. Takedown. Yeah, okay, we got rid of him. And here is more Pokemon, still not the boss. It's a long battle. I mean, it is the final level of World 4, so we'll just have to wait and see. Like, it's maybe possible to survive all of this, but it's gonna have to be like a, we'll have to see about it, you know? It's up in the air whether we'll survive or not. Come on, okay, that was hitting you pretty good. We got a couple more items. We're still only halfway for Fearow. And here's the boss, whoa, it's a Machamp. Okay, so let's go ahead and use, actually might wanna use Whirlwind against you because you're in a corner over here, which could be really good for us. Let's use Supersonic. Here comes, oh gosh, we're surrounded. We're surrounded in a really bad way. I need you to use Leech Life very soon. Just like this. This is horrifying. This is really horrifying. Come on, come on. Use Takedown one more time before you get taken out again. And then, okay, that was, you are not taking any damage because we've been focusing on your friends, but now you're really taking some hits. Okay, come on, use Gust on you. Use Gust, Fearow's down again. But you're sort of like in this corner. We're backing up for some reason. We're just scared. Like, ah, get out of here. Come on, ready, set, leash life. Oh, that got him almost back up to full. Zubat is so good. Got that. Awesome. Come on, come on, come on. Leash life again. Almost back up to full health with you. Fearow's almost up as well, which will be a nice distraction. And did you immediately get taken down again? The poor thing. Oh, I feel bad. Just constantly use leech life and we'll just stay up at full health. Maybe we'll be able to win that way. Come on, we're about to beat him. We beat him. Yes, we beat World 4. That was really, really tough, but I guess you don't need to match the thing entirely. Okay, so we got it. And I wonder what cool stuff we'll end up getting for all of that. It looks like a decent chunk of stuff. 201 for that sturdy stone, but it didn't have any special effects. So I don't know how great it really will be. But there we go, yeah, look at that thing. You discovered a tranquility statue. Congratulations, now your Pokemon up to level 20 can get increased experience from expeditions. I've discovered another new statue, that makes 4 now. Okay, this is the tranquility statue. The statue is carved in the shape of a Cubone. If one can find peace, perhaps one can overcome even death. That is definitely true. So with that being said, what is this one over here? Oh. There are more areas to explore nearby. Perhaps we should head out on another expedition? Yes, we should, but I just want to sort of check this out. So our recommended is much lower. Bonus type is water. Gotta keep that in mind. I think what we'll do for the rest of today's episode, because we're a little short right now, I should probably spend the rest of today's episode earning up more Pokemon and trying to level up water Pokemon. So let's get to that. We, of course, got a water Pokemon earlier in today's episode. It was the Seahorse. You've completed a main quest, would you like to check it out? Yes. What is this? Ooh, we got a recharge on our battery, awesome. That'll be great. What is this, pincushion plane? Clear pincushion plane, we haven't done that just yet. So, go back this way and see what Pokemon we get. It's gotta be good, right? It's gotta be good. It's a mulligan, so it really can be anything. Oh, it's new. It's definitely new. What in the world? Oh, it's a Tangela. Wow, you're interesting. You actually have a lot of stats. Are you a water type? No, you're a grass type. Weird, you seem more like a water type to me. Okay, well, I'll take what I can get. We're gonna go ahead and load everything up. I think it would be good to do another bronze one. We have 266 berries, 327 mushrooms. Start cooking, you bet. Okay, so let's figure out our team a little bit, but also I need to set out some decorations just in case they do, you know, matter to be out. See, let's place you somewhere if I can. Hold on, where can I put you? Is there any space for you right now? I don't know, I don't think so. It's a bit of a problem. I just sort of have to hope that it really is true that we don't need you guys out. Okay, so we'll put that there for now. because it's a Cubone. Very cool stuff. And now I can edit my team. So let's take a look for water types. I think that's gonna be best for us. So you're a sand type, you're Sandshrew. We have Growlithe, Fearow. Goldene is definitely a good choice. Let's get you in like that. And then other water types. Lapras for sure is gonna be a huge help. So if we could grab you, come on. I know. Go like that. And then finally, we could either do Krabby or we could do Horsey. The thing is that you're melee, you're ranged. We could go for it. Oh gosh, no, I just wanna, there we go. It's not very high leveled, of course, so that's a bit of a problem, but if we did wanna do Krabby, the thing is that this Krabby's actually better, has like way better stats, but it has a power charm. But I don't think it's a power charm that would really make too much of a difference. If we take a long looky, if we hold and click, you have what? No. Some kind of defensive move. It looks like that's all the spots you have for a move. Well, you have two moves. So you're definitely the better Krabby. So if we go into training, we're gonna train up the weaker Krabby because that one's better. So yeah, go ahead and put you here and then put the weaker Krabby or the stronger Krabby there, bring you up to level 13, not bad. And is there any other duplicate Pokemon we wanna throw into the mix? I don't think so. We'll just leave it like that for now. And start our training. So you'll get experience from that. Because you also had the better stats, so I think it's totally worth it. Because I think he had more damage than the other one. And then there's also move learning, but I think he's pretty good with the moves he's got. So we could do Krabby instead of Horsey, but I think I need to go back to the team slot to find out what Horsey has as abilities and stuff. Because I definitely wanna keep Lapras. Goldene is like really powerful right now, so I think I wanna keep her. But how do I check out what abilities you have? I think I have to click and hold like that. Or maybe I have to go to the power charm panel. I mean, I don't know how much more time I'll spend on this, but if I can just upgrade these guys a little bit more, it would be great for next episode. So you have Aqua Jet. The user charges at enemies in front of itself with tremendous speed, dealing damage to them. And then you also have Takedown, which is pretty normal. Okay, so we have that. If we move over to you, you have a couple of moves, right? You have Agility. The user relaxes and lightens its body, raising its movement speed for a while. And then finally, you also have Bubble. The user fires bubbles in three directions, deals damage to enemies hit by bubbles, but and sometimes lowers their movement speed. Okay, I'm thinking that we will take Krabby over Horsey, even though Horsey's so cute. I definitely need to boost your HP as much as we possibly can because you're gonna be in the forefront being one of the melee characters, so doing that would be good. And then also maybe even giving you this one. Okay, so we'll move back to the other one soon. I wanna go back to our team. I know I'm taking so long in this, I apologize, but it's worth my while as far as I can tell. So let's go ahead over Horsey, we're gonna get Krabby. No, come on. Just like that. It'll even boost our team a little bit. I mean, he has a power charm, so it's not too unexpected, but we can give him even better power charm soon enough. Right now, he's got some pretty good stuff, but I think we're gonna go ahead and do this and then give him some good damage. Definitely make him a hard hitter. Yeah, we'll do this and then we'll save this one for somebody else. If I move back to Lapras, how's Lapras doing with everything? She has definitely some room for improvement. I think that she should get this damage stone, but then also if she wants another damage stone, it should probably be a weaker one if we can manage, because we need some benefits for the other characters. So something like this might be good because this will make her movement speed a little bit better. I don't really know if that's all that useful for her. I mean, it might be better just to, no, that's more movement speed. Okay, that won't be very useful. This right here, HP upon recovery, time to recover, isn't very helpful for a ranged character. So I think this combo is pretty good. Then move back to Goldene where she still has a couple of slots available. I'm thinking that we can get whatever damage upgrade that's not, you know, taken by other Pokemon in our team. Then we can get this one as well. And there we go, we got some beefy Pokemon going on right now. This is great. So let's take a look at all this. I think that we can at least get a couple battles done. Where do I want to get them done is the question. I'm not sure, because I don't want to start with World 5 until next episode and until I'm plenty ready to do so, you know? So if we could just sort of jam out with this for a little bit and see how everything goes, I think that would be great. I mean, right now, our score is pretty good, 29-41, and if we were to take a look, how would, like, things go when we hop into here? We would jump up 1496. It would be already 3,900, and then, like, yeah, 3,900, so like 4,000 something. So I'd get us the first couple levels into there. So that's what we're doing next episode. Let's just go ahead and have a round or two and maybe even complete most of our cooking pots. We'll do, you know, World 3. I think that's gonna be pretty good. And hopefully everything will go well. But yeah, thank you guys so much for your support on the series. We've been having so much fun with this game. And you guys have been requesting it like crazy, more of it. So I'm glad to deliver. So this time we have a little bit of a different combo because it's two melee. Oh wow, we are destroying these guys. We get tons of materials this way as well. But we got two melee and one range instead of one range, or two range and one melee. And I think it'll make our team a little bit more bulky, but we're gonna have to see. So we're doing Ice Wind. This time we're having a bit of a harder time. We'll do Aqua Jet. That's a pretty cool move right there. I like Golding. Golding is pretty helpful. And then Icy Wind. Gotcha. Aqua Jet again. You just like tackle him. It's great. And these guys like aren't as high level as some of the Pokemon we just had. So we're definitely gonna get a lot of level ups because of the statue. So hopefully everything works out well with that. We'll give you Harden, but I don't know if it'll actually be all that helpful. But yeah, let's go ahead and do Surf, just like that. Wow, okay, more of them pop up right in front of us. That saves us some time, which is good. But I'll probably do this one more time after this. I don't wanna use too many of my batteries because I do need to save them for next episode. Because I don't know if I'll record that right after this. I'm having so much fun, I really want to, but I might have to wait to make sure we have as many batteries as possible and try as many things as possible. We'll have to just wait and see. So we're surfing at people, we're aqua jetting them. It's working out really well, and we're taking it on fellow water types. Look at how many materials we have, 60, almost 70 of them. Okay, so, more slow pokes. Yeah, that's right, we have this guy as the boss, the slow bro. But yeah, going back and playing older levels, especially if you do it on auto, can be very helpful. It's what I suggest you do if you're like, you're busy, but you wanna play the, like you wanna make sure your Pokemon are leveled up. A lot of people seem to be like, what the heck, why is there an auto? But it totally makes sense. Now that I've actually played the game, I think it's really awesome. Because it just, it helps me enjoy the game when I wanna play it, but also still be able to have my Pokemon leveled up without having to like grind all the time. And it does make the game significantly more enjoyable because of it. So I think the people maybe who are judging it for the auto haven't played into it too much, because I think it's really solid of an idea. So many different materials, there are 84 of them. Insanity. And, ooh, almost another Power Stone slot for another character there. 95 damage isn't too great, but I'm glad to have it. It's just more things we can recycle if we need to. Oh, and we got two cooking pots done. So we're gonna do one more battle after this and see how things go. Or maybe we'll do a couple. If I'm gonna stop playing after this, maybe we should just hold on. What do we get? We got another Mulligan Stew, and I'm gonna probably keep to bronze cooking pots if we're gonna earn up this much. Pikachu! We gotcha! Oh, look at that, we got another Pikachu. That's so great. This guy's level 6 though, so he isn't too crazy. But we already had one Pikachu, right? Somewhere. There's so many Pokemon around, it's hard to see them all. We do have another Pikachu somewhere. He might just not be out right now. I don't think this is all of our Pokemon. Where can we check? Yeah, we also have a level 14 Pikachu. Very, very cool. So let's see what we get for this other one. Maybe another cool Pokemon. It's gonna be another Mulligan, but that's fine. I'm gonna make them all bronze next time. That'll make it a little bit better, I think. It's another Zubat. That's great. I can level up my other Zubat with this Zubat because my other Zubat's like perfect. I love him. So Zubat became your buddy. What is this move? That's new to me, Taunt. The user taunts surrounding enemies, forcing them to target it. I don't know if I like that too much though. See, we're definitely going to put, like train the other Zubat with you. I think that'd be really great. We might do that right now. First off though, let's go ahead and upgrade this to gold, or bronze, not gold, and get some of those, start our cooking. Yep, yep, yep. And then right here we have, that's gonna take six. That's gonna take a long time then. Because we have so many materials, it's a lot of fun. Okay, so that's all cooking up. We're not gonna have another one for a little while now. So yeah, let's go back to edit team. I'm definitely gonna level up the Zubat with the training, if not anything else, so let's get to it. Because what level is Zubat right now? Zubat is level 21, so if we do this and then find the other Zubat, which is right over here, this should give us a good bonus, I think. Oh, no, 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 this is move learning. Don't want that. I would have been so upset. if we like, because it's a 100% chance if you had the same type, but I really don't want to learn his moves. Okay, start the training. Boom. So sorry there, little guy. I just got you. That's level 22. Yes, we got the evolution. Pokemon evolutions all day today. I am so happy. And this time we get, look at him. He is just so impartial. I was like, yeah, whatever, I'm Golbat. Yeah, congratulations, your Zubat evolved into a Golbat. Awesome stuff. I am so happy about that. So we got ourselves a Pharaoh, we got ourselves a Golbat, everything is good in the world. Let's get a couple more training sessions in with this group of Pokemon. They should be getting a lot of experience because of the fact that we have the new statue that makes it so that they can get up to level 20 a bit easier. So if I could just get a couple more done, that'd be great. So let's get to it. Maybe I should move over to this level. I mean, what is our score now? 29-41. So this would be tough, but it's doable. And this will give us the most experience, I think. Maybe, we'll find out. Expedition start. I wish there really was like an auto and a speed up. I thought that'd make this game even more convenient, but at the same time, maybe that'd be too much. But let's go ahead and do Icy Wind. We will do Surf. This team is very, very on the offense in a way. With the Aqua Jet and the Surf, we can just charge characters constantly, just like boom. And then, oh, you think you're done? You think you're done? No, you're not. And then we could Icy Wind if I wanted to, but I don't want to right now. Now we can. And we still can heal ourselves with Lapras. So we got like a great combo of everything. And it's gonna get even better once we get more Power Stones and we continue upgrading our team for next world. Ooh, we got a Power Stone there. I mean, I think for this world, a lot of it's not gonna be too crazy. I'm gonna be able to recycle the most of it. Okay, so we got a couple of purple Pokemon. Oh, what was that noise? That was a weird noise. I don't like it. I can hit a couple people that way, but we all sort of ran into each other. It was a little awkward. I think this Nidoran's making that noise. Makes me uncomfortable. Okay, do a takedown, because that does some good damage as well. And then we can do Surf that way. You are just flying all over the place over there, buddy. Okay, good stuff. We got this one last one before the boss, I think. Okay, so where's that boss fight at? So there we go, there's Machoke. Okay, so let's go ahead and do Icy Wind. We are taking a bit of a beating. This definitely is a little bit more difficult, for sure. We're getting a lot of materials, though, which is great. And then do Icy Wind, Icy Wind, Icy Wind. Okay, now we can all focus in on the boss. I think it'll make things a little bit easier. Krabby's a little low, so I might make him harden. And then we can do that. Icy Wind again, as soon as you can. But also Surf. There we go, Icy Wind now. Because it all knocks him back. Like, we were just like bouncing him around. I sort of feel bad for the guy. And nobody got taken out as well, so that's really, really good. I'm so happy. Got bunches of mushrooms, over 50 material. As long as I'm getting over 50 per round, I think that's good, because that's technically a bronze chest worth of items. Well, yeah, you guys get a lot there. Ooh, a new slot, that's gonna help so much. The slots really help boost your power more than anything, because then you can put more things that are like, you know, if we get 100 power there, 146, that's gonna be huge, because that's just 146 more of the total power. So I've been learning a lot more about this game, and that's a huge help to you guys, or from a huge amount of help for you guys. So thank you so much for all of the wonderful advice you've been giving me. So, what do we want to mix up though? Because we got 146 damage here, and actually, who had some? Lapras and Goldeen. So we could actually, I think Lapras could use the damage boost. So let's go ahead and give this to him, or her, I don't know. It doesn't say the gender, so I'm just gonna say whatever feels right. So yeah, put that there. That'll be a little bit of a boost, which is pretty good. And then I think, yeah, you had your upgrade. So what was that, a health or a damage? I think it was a damage, yeah. So we don't have too many options for you with that, but I think we'll just go ahead and give you the 131. Like I said, that's 131 more power than what you had before. So you can't go wrong with that. And then we had, I thought, a health upgrade. Was it this one? Maybe. Some of these aren't too crazy, but I'm thinking that I might like trade out this. No, no, no. Does anybody have like a flat health that doesn't have any bonuses around here? Not really, but the gold is good. It's better than bronze. Time to recover, movement speed. Well, that's actually for Fear Out. Okay, I'm getting that confused. Silly me. Who on this team has the lowest health? I guess you, the lowest health upgrade. Guess it's you. But why do we have this here? Okay. I mean, we could probably upgrade something. Maybe for Lapras? Maybe getting a little confused with the Power Stones. I need to do a better job at all of this managing. Well, I guess we don't have too many openings for health. Like Lapras, I can't wait until she gets all of these. That's gonna make her crazy. But that's why she starts with so many health, or so much health to begin with, is because of that. So we'll do one more battle for today's episode, and then we'll wrap everything up. I'm having such a blast, though. I don't want to stop. And we'll just go against that same battle. So yeah, we're gonna be very prepared, because we're gonna get plus like 1500 power just for being as powerful as we are when we head into the next world. So our team right now is gonna work out great. Having this like typing advantage is definitely fantastic. These guys are gonna go down real quick. Come on, get him, get him, got him. Okay, we got more Pokemon over that way. I'm gonna use Icy Wind first. So do that, and then Aqua Jet him. Nice, and then we can, oh, that was a waste of Surf, but it's okay. Already got our first chunk of materials. Can hit him with that. Oh, I hit all of them, great. I only hit you with that one. The Surf seems to be the most reliable when hitting multiple units. I mean the Icy Wind as well, because it goes right through everybody. Okay, here's the group of Nidoran and Ekans. Got it. Then we can Aqua Jet. And I might still like continue to level up between levels. I mean, at the same time, I'm really worried we might get like an evolution between levels, which I really don't want. But I really don't know. Does Krabby evolve into anything? Does Goldeen evolve into anything? I'm not really too familiar with this Pokemon. I'm pretty sure Lapras is the final evolution. I don't know if Lapras has anything before or after. I think it's just Lapras, like Snorlax, right? That might be wrong. I might be totally wrong. I try to be as familiar with Pokemon as I can, but it's clear that I'm not a Pokemon master just yet. Okay, we got Machoke. So we're gonna go ahead and do Harden right away, and then we're gonna take down Icy Wind. Try to get rid of all of his friends as soon as possible. That sounds so awful when you say it that way. Get rid of his friends. Aqua Jet for sure. There we go. I think we hit more than one unit with that. Getting rid of those two will be really, really helpful. Now we'll get his focus all on a Machoke. I think we'll be able to get him. I mean, we just took him out a moment ago, so if we do worse this time, it'd be a little confusing. Okay, I did Harden again. Not exactly what I wanted to do, but at the same time, he's quite low on health. It might be worth our while. Okay, they're really beating him up. Okay, we got him. No takedowns again. This combo is better than when it was with Fearow. I think that when there's two melee characters, the boss will sort of jump between the two, which makes it confusing for him, but very beneficial for us. Okay, so people are getting some level ups, which is very good. If I could get Krabby and Lapras level 20 before next episode, I think that would bring me really far. We got even better stones, which is great. But I really think that's where I gotta wrap it up for today's episode. I'm like seriously running out of time. So thank you guys so much. Be excited, be ready. We're gonna take on Belly Button Cave in the next episode, where hopefully we'll have enough for everything. Right now we already have 4595, holy cow. So hopefully we truly can handle everything. There's only one way to find out, and that's to tackle it in the next episode of Pokemon Quest. If you watch this part of the video, make sure you comment Evolved Zebra, so now you watch at the end of that you're a Zebra-tastic viewer. Check out more episodes like this one on your screen right now, or by subscribing to join the Zebra Herd. Either way, thank you guys so much for watching. I'll see you next time. Bye-bye.